Seth Lutheran Church. I know we're just getting the stream up and going, so welcome to all of you, and we'll say welcome to everybody else once they're on. Today marks Indigenous Peoples Sunday. Our liturgy comes from a liturgy that many churches in the ELCA across the country will use today. I think it has some beautiful themes of relationship and of lament and repair and also creation. And considering it's fall, I thought it was the perfect time to wear my new stole, which I'm really excited about. It's very nice. Other announcements this morning for the good of the community. Yes?
Just a reminder that tomorrow evening at 5:30 is a welcome meeting here at the church.
Tomorrow evening, 5:30, welcome meeting. Did we get it up and going?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, welcome to everyone online. Other announcements, yes?
I finally remembered to bring the box for the Damiano Center, and it's back in the corner. For hats, jackets, just anything in good condition for new if you want to bring new. And then next, the Social Ministry is serving coffee for Welcome Home Ranch, and Lynn Beattie will be our speaker. So I have a lot of people coming. Thank you.
Wonderful. So hats, jackets, gloves in the box until the end of November, something like that. For a while.
The first weekend in December, the first Sunday, that's when Seth will come from down.
Wonderful. Other announcements this morning? Let us rise and worship God together, and we will begin today with a call to worship. The Spirit of God, the Creator, and of Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Come, let us worship God and seek right relationships with our neighbors.
Come, let us worship our Creator with hearts open to all God's people.
Let us worship our Creator with minds open to the wisdom of our native neighbors, where listening and respect once had no place.
Let us honor the one who freely gives to all.
Let us worship the God of creation, who made the world in colors, in seasons, in endless variety, who created all the earth's diverse peoples in God's own image.
We were created to honor one another. In doing so, we honor the Creator.
Let us honor God by reflecting the Creator's love in our worship and in our lives.
Amen.
What's the hymn number? Do you have that
thing
together
with you? Yeah, I know it's
white page number 9.
White page number 9 in the black hymn book. Sorry about that. White page number 9. Yeah, if you were a little confused by that, so were the rest of us.
Should we start with the first verse again?
Sure, yeah. Let's start the whole thing over. White page number 9.
Thank you.
together, we remember our baptism. We face the east, to your symbol of gold, to the sunrise which shows us that Creator God loves us as a parent, and to the rivers of the east that give us life. We bring the life you have given us, O God, in the waters of the Susquehanna River, and we pray.
Come, Holy Creator. Come, Holy Spirit.
We turn to the south, to your symbol of white, to life and growth and the warmth of the sun, through which Creator God gives us food for our journey of life. We bring the life you have given us, O God, in the waters of the Rio Grande, and we pray.
Come, Holy Creator. Come, Holy Spirit.
We turn to the west, to your symbol of black, to sunset and the end of this and every day, and the worlds beyond to which you beckon us, Great Spirit. We thank you for the ancestors who have gone before. We bless you with the waters of the Colorado River, which have given us life. And we pray.
Come, Holy Creator. Come, Holy Spirit.
And we turn to the north, to your symbol of red. We look to God, our Creator, who cleanses our earth with snow, wind, and rain, and Jesus, who fills us with the wideness of mercy and grace, and lovingly embraces all God's people. We bless you for the life-giving water of the Mississippi River, and we pray.
Come, Holy Creator. Come, Holy Spirit.
Let us pray.
Creator, to you we give thanks in all you bring. As we walk our holy journey together, open our hearts to your presence. Open our minds to understanding. Open our eyes to see the way. Open our ears to hear the stories of your children. Help us to speak with honor and respect to all people. For with your Spirit we can face the winds together.
Amen.
Please be seated as we hear the word.
Good morning.
Good morning.
A reading from 2 Timothy, 2 chapter, verses 8 to 15. Though Paul is chained as a prisoner, the word of God is never shackled or confined. Timothy is encouraged to proclaim that word of freedom in an honest and upright life, as well as his teaching and preaching. Remember Jesus Christ raised from the dead, a descendant of David. That is my gospel, for which I suffer hardship, even to the point of being chained like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, so that they may also obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus with eternal glory. The saying is sure. If we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful. For he cannot deny himself. Remind them of this and warn them before God that they are to avoid wrangling over words, which does no good but only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by him, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly explaining the word of truth, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read responsibly from Psalm 111. Hallelujah! I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart, in the assembly of the upright, in the congregation.
Great are your works, O Lord, honored by all who delight in them.
Majesty and splendor mark your deeds, and your righteousness endures forever.
You cause your wonders to be remembered. You are gracious and full of compassion.
You give food to those who fear you, remembering forever your covenant.
You have shown your people the power of your works, in giving them the lands of the nations.
The works of your hands are faithfulness and justice. All of your precepts are sure.
They stand fast forever and ever, because they are done in truth and equity.
You sent redemption to your people and commanded your covenant forever. Holy and awesome is your name.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. All who practice this
according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered a village there, 10 lepers approached him. And keeping their distance, they cried out to him, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priest." And as they were on their way, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Were none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then Jesus said to him, "Get up and go. Your faith has made you well." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Today we have something a little bit different, and that is what Matt Cobb calls a dialogue sermon. Now, Matt Cobb is in our synod, the director of Together Here Ministries, which, if you haven't heard of it, you can pick out a little bit from the name about what it is. Together Here Ministries is a ministry across our synod, Northeast Minnesota, that seeks to help churches and congregations live together here with our indigenous siblings. So they do all kinds of things to support our relationships and our work with our neighbors. And Matt Cobb is brand new to our synod, but he's not brand new to this work. He was a missionary for several years in India. He's been both a pastor and a teacher, and he is now in our synod doing this work. And today he did what's called a dialogue sermon with a lay leader in the Episcopal Church whose name is Reagan Morgan. Now, Reagan Morgan is an enrolled member of the Leech Lake Band of Ojibwe. And Reagan, his great-great-grandfather, was Chief Linji, who had his encampment on the south side of what is now Lake Ubuntu. If you can consult the map in your head, as my brother would say, Reagan is also a lay worship leader in the Episcopal Church. And today they talked about Jesus as our friend. In just a few minutes, we're going to play a video of the two of them talking about this text and also the text of Hebrew 13. Verse 8. Now, chapter 13, verse 8 reads, "Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever." They talk about Jesus as our friend, the bond of friendship that we have with God. And the other thing you need to know before listening to this, the part of this dialogue sermon, is they say a word in Ojibwe, which is Nij. And I asked Matt, because he didn't tell us what it means, I asked him this week what that means. And he said the word Nij is like the word Niji, which means friend, but it's shortened. So it's even more a sign of affection. So when he says the word Nij, and when Reagan says Nij, they mean not just friend, but almost brother or sister. It's a bond of closeness and affection, is Nij. So we're going to play, I'm going to have this video play, and I'll help Donald put it up. And it's about 5 minutes. But I invite you to listen closely, because I think there's a really profound and important message for us about Jesus in our lives, if we can listen closely. And then after the video, I'll let it speak for itself for a moment. We'll sit and reflect, and then we'll return here to our service. So, yeah, you can exit out, and then it's the orange kind of.
Yeah. So I appreciate the opportunity to come to you from this this place of spirit, this place of good news, this place where Jesus is in the center of this sacred circle, which is church. This is our Indigenous Peoples Sunday. We acknowledge and appreciate and accept that we are all guests here, and we can journey together and learn how to be together here in this place. So, from Together Here Ministries to everyone in the Northeastern Minnesota Synod of the ELCA, Evangelical Lutheran Church of America, I say, be with you. Thank you.
Maybe you couldn't see it very well. So, if we would have zoomed in a little bit, we would have seen a representation of the face of Jesus. So they were talking about Jesus and their friendship with Jesus. And they were talking also about the poem that was about Jesus' friendship with us. Now, I wonder, how do we as Christians, or how do you talk to Jesus or talk to God? How can we talk to God? By praying. Yeah, by praying. Do you know any prayers? Have you learned any prayers with your parents or in Sunday school? Yeah. You learned the Lutheran prayer? Yeah, that's a good one. What's that one about? What are some of the words? You don't have to say the whole thing. Okay, what about you, Lily? Remember any prayers? Like the Lord's Prayer, is that what you're thinking of? Yeah. The Lord's Prayer, that's a good one too. So some prayers, we learn them and we say them over and over again. We pray them over and over again. And they, kind of like that poem or that picture, they can sometimes offer us friendship or healing from God because we're shaped by them. But we can also pray what we are thinking or what we are feeling. And that also is a way of that we receive healing and receive friendship from God. So why don't we have a prayer together right now? Let's pray together. You can all repeat after me. Let's pray.
Dear Jesus,
thank you for your friendship.
Thank you for your friendship.
And thank you for your healing.
And thank you for your healing.
Be with us and keep us.
Be with us and keep us.
Each and every day.
Each and every day.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. I'll invite you to rise, and together we will enter into a time both of confession of faith and of lament. Christians have often focused on what separated us from native people, rather than looking for what united us. Failing to seek or find a harmonious life together resulted in the deaths of hundreds of thousands of native people and the forced assimilation of people.
As God's children, we lament the hurt and destruction caused by the sins of the past and present.
6 years ago, our church, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, adopted the repudiation of the doctrine of discovery. This resolution calls upon the church to do many things, including to reject the false teaching that this land was unclaimed before European settlers arrived.
As baptized disciples, we renounce evil and falsehood, and we reject the false teaching of discovery.
We believe in a God who seeks ever-deepening relationships. We are reminded that with repentance also comes the work of change in hearts and actions.
As God's church, we ask God to deepen our relationships with our native neighbors.
We believe in a Savior who brings healing.
As Christ's church, we ask God to create in us hope and new life.
Done to indigenous people, the lives and cultures lost to colonialism, we know that actions taken by ourselves and by others have caused pain and death. We grieve and lament today the ways in which we have struggled to tell the truth of this sin. We struggle to follow your will, that all be one in the truth of the gospel. O God of mercy,
receive our prayer.
Today we lament and confess that even in the face of truth we have been stubborn. We have ignored the voices of our indigenous siblings. We have failed to stand up to oppression. We have resisted repair and reconciliation. O God, help us. O God of mercy,
receive our prayer.
We lament today our our own ways of thinking and acting that continue the divisions of the past. As communities and as individuals, we build many walls around us, mental, spiritual, physical, and political walls that result in discrimination and violence. Forgive us, Lord. O God, have mercy.
Receive our prayer.
We believe that Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. We believe that Christ is our peace who breaks down the walls that divide, who gives us through the Holy Spirit ever new beginnings. So show us true repentance and reconciliation this day. O God of mercy,
receive our prayer.
For Christ's sake, we receive forgiveness from God, and we are strengthened for the long and hard work of repentance and reconciliation, working toward a faithful and just witness in our time. Teach us the way to true repentance and reconciliation. O God of mercy,
receive our prayer.
Creator, you made the world, and you declared it good. The beauty of the leaves, the softness of the air, the dew of the grass, they speak to us. The summit of the hills, the thunder of the sky, the rhythm of the lakes, they speak to us. The faintness of the stars, the freshness of the morning, the calm of the evening, they speak to us. But above all, our hearts soar, for you come to us in your Son, Jesus Christ, and in the Holy Spirit. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Please share with one another a sign of the peace of Christ.
Oh my God.
Thank you.
Please rise as you're able. And let us pray. Gracious God, in your great love, you richly provide for our needs. Make of these gifts a banquet of blessing, and make us ready to share with all in need. Through Jesus Christ, who sets the table for all. Amen. We come to the table, knowing that all our siblings in Christ are welcome. For this table does not belong to us. It belongs to the Lord. So know today that you are welcome here without reservation or regard. We commune today by coming forward, receiving a piece of bread and then a cup on either side. All of the bread is gluten-free, and the cups, the purple is wine, and the white is grape juice. Once you've eaten and drinking, you can return your cup to the bowl on each side. And finally, if you would like to commune from your seats, let someone in the back know, and they'll get you a cup for you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is better to give our thanks and praise.
He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take this and eat it. For this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Then after supper, Jesus took a cup. He gave thanks to God for it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this and drink it. For this is the cup of the new covenant, which is for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom, and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Come, for all are welcome, and all is good. Please rise as you are able. Let us pray.
God of the abundant table,
you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road, that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Children of God, receive this blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and with mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Amen.
Beside you.